What I'd like to share is looking at, for oxidative stress, free radical damage, scanning the blood morphology, looking at the shape and the quality of the cells, and comparing that with the lipid profile for triglycerides, cholesterol, glucose, HDL, LDL. And I'd like to review with you, Dr. Doug Lear, have you ever had this test done before?
A while back.
Okay, good. We're going to take a look now, since we know that blood is very dynamic and it does change from time to time. But one thing I've noticed extraordinarily, and that is that when blood dries, these little red blood cells, millions of red blood cells there on, form a pattern. And this pattern is almost like a fingerprint. It comes up fairly consistently in people when they continue to do the same thing repetitively. Now, if you make a big change in your exercise, or in your diet, or in your supplementation, even your emotional state, as you know, can make a big difference in overall health and the quality at the cellular level of the blood. So what we're looking at is really healthy-looking blood. We're seeing that there's very little free radical damage or oxidative stress. Now, would you say that your diet is flexitarian, vegetarian, omnivore, mixed? How would you classify your diet at this time?
Probably a mixed organic diet of plant and non-plant based foods.
And okay.
The last couple days we did a special vegan for the last 48 hours.
Oh, okay. Okay, very good.
All right, so.
Leading up to this test?
Correct.
Excellent. Okay. Now, how have you been with your exercise in the last, say, 3 months? Fairly consistent, and if so, what kind of exercise? Or very little time for exercise? Where have you been with your exercise?
Not consistent, because I've been traveling. On and off.
Got it.
On planes and
multiple
cities.
Got it.
Since I've been back, I walk a couple miles every other day.
Okay.
And do a little short burst yoga for 5-10 minutes.
Got it.
Active.
Okay. So you have extraordinarily very little free radical damage. What we do see is just showing up these little pocket areas here and there, and it's within the tolerance of normal acceptability. The only other way to cross-reference and say what your level of free radical damage would be to send it off to do lipid peroxidase from a major laboratory, and maybe a breath analysis that measures the amount of oxidative stress too. So we see a little bit of fat in the blood, not much. What did you have today leading up to this test for breakfast and lunch?
Organic steel cut oats.
Uh-huh.
For breakfast.
Any milk in the oats?
No.
Okay.
No.
Okay.
I never do that anyway.
Good.
And if I eat dairy, it'll be some raw cheese.
Okay.
That's occasional.
All right.
What else? We had some peach.
Uh huh.
A little bit of peach.
Yeah.
And that's it. Our breakfast, and then lunch was a salad with a little tahini on it.
Looks really good. The shape of your cells is excellent. Really nice. They're pretty much all round and uniform. I rarely give people an ideal score on that, so this is looking very good so far. I think overall, I would suggest over the next 30 days that we look at ways to continue to optimize your health, allow the white blood cells to calm down a little bit, maybe some medicinal mushrooms, some activated barley, because it's acts like an adaptogen. So if the white cells are a little bit high, it'll calm them down a little bit. If they're a little too low, it helps to support them a little bit better. Okay, good. I think we've got you on track then to do what needs to be done. Is there any overall questions that you have on what we've looked at?
No, only a few recommends on a few of your products, and we're good to go.
Okay, thank you.
Great, thanks.